So, very good afternoon, everyone. I am very sorry, since long time I have not uploaded any video. In spite of many of you have asked me to upload, but I didn't. So sorry for it. I just now seen what we have covered in last video, and if you remember, we have talked about the phases of the clinical trials. And today's I am going to discuss a little bit about the various design of clinical trial. In my observations, what I feel and question is asked on the types of clinical trial, particularly the students are writing about the phases, students are writing on the design of clinical trial, but that is completely wrong. If the question is on types of clinical trial, then you have to be right. Prevention trials, diagnostic trials, treatment trial, these are the actually the types of the clinical trial. But when question is asked on phases, then you have to write phase 0, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, phase 4. And if question is specifically on design of clinical trial, then you have to write these design of clinical trial. This one is parallel design, crossover design, pictorial design, adaptive design. So today's I am going to discuss one by one what actually the parallel design. So parallel design, as its name indicate, as you all knows, before starting a clinical trials, we have to do the screening. If we are designing for a phase 1 clinical trials, then we have to screen the volunteers whether they are healthy or not. If we are going to recruit a subject or patients for particularly for phase 2 or phase 3 trials, then accordingly we have to be do their screening. So after screening of the volunteers or the subjects, volunteer terms you have to use when we are talking about the phase 1 clinical trial or phase 0 clinical trial or bioequivalent studies. And subject we have to use when one is going to talk about phase 2 clinical trial, phase 3 clinical trials. So in parallel group of design of the trials, as after screening of these subjects or volunteers, you have to do the randomizations of the subjects or volunteers and blinding procedures. And in randomizations, you have to divide according to your protocol designs into a one arm is the control group, another group will be your treatment group or standard group, depending upon your particular protocol. So, in parallel design of the clinical trials, what actually in parallel design is, after randomization, suppose one group you are giving a placebo and another group you are giving a test drugs. So, for the entire duration of the trials, you have to continue that treatment. So, if suppose trial is for 3 months, then for entire 3 months, the subject after randomization, the subject in the control group will get only that control, means if in control you are using a placebo, then for the entire durations you have to give the placebo, whether it is for 3 months or 6 months, whatever the trial duration is. And another group, if you are giving a treatment or test drug, then that group will receive test drug for the entire duration of the trial. So that is actually the parallel design of clinical trial, and we are mostly preferring for phase 2 and phase 3 clinical trial parallel design. The limitations of parallel design is actually intra-subject variations is much more. So that will be high in a parallel designs, and particularly these designs are time consuming also, and large number of subjects are required to complete the clinical trials. So this is a parallel design, and second design of clinical trial is, if you see this PPTs, there is a crossover. So crossover, as its name indicate, in crossover design, after randomizations, it's for the entire duration of the trials, you will not get a same treatment. So the control group will not get a same treatment, or test group will not get a same treatment for the entire durations of the clinical trials, because it's a crossover. So after certain period, that treatment will be crossover among the groups. If I give you examples, suppose in one group you are giving a placebo, second group you are giving a test drugs, and your trial duration is 2 months. So after 1 month, what you have did, the subjects who are getting a placebo, now you have switched over the treatment. You have given them a test drug, and the subject who are getting earlier test drug, now they are getting a placebo. So that is we call crossover. You have used the same subject or volunteers to study the effect of the drugs. So these crossover design are mostly preferred for bioequivalence studies or phase 1 clinical trials. But the question is, on what basis you will select that after that period you will cross over the treatment. So it will depend upon T half of that particular drug or particular molecules. And as you know, as per basic pharmacokinetic knowledge, the maximum drug will be eliminated from the bodies after 4 to 5 T half. So if I would give you the examples, suppose T half of the drug is 2 hours and you are going to use a crossover. So the question is, after what times you can cross over the treatments. So if T half is 2 hours, multiply it by 5, 4 or 5, 5, and after 10 hours, the more than 95% of the drug will be eliminated from the body, and after that you can switch over the treatment. So that will be called washout period. So it's required. Otherwise, the drug-drug interaction can happen, and you can't compare the results. So these crossover designs are most preferred, as I told you, for bioequivalence and phase 1 clinical trials, and particularly for the drugs whose T half is not too long. Sometimes some drugs have a very long T half. So in that cases, suppose T half is 500 or 200, then you have to multiply by 5. So it required much more time to eliminate from the bodies, and after the eliminations you can switch over the treatment. So in what years in crossover designs, the advantage of crossover design is intra-subject variability is less. If you think a little bit closely, you will find that because we are giving the treatment of that particular, suppose placebo, as well as the drug in the same subject, so the variation among the subject will be reduced, because you are giving first, suppose I am taking a placebo, then after the washout period I am taking the test drug. So same effect is seen in individuals, means in the same subject. So automatically your intra subject variability is less in crossover design. And another is because you are using the same subjects for two treatments. So automatically your number of volunteers or number of subjects will be less, less as compared to parallel group of design. So another group of design is factorial design, as again these all are self-explanatory, and factorial means you prefer this design if you are going to measure the effect of your drug on a different factors. Suppose you want to check the effect of that particular new chemical entities or the drugs on blood pressures, on cholesterol, on weight or other factors. So two or three factors you want to compare. So in that case you have to be prefer the factorial design. Another, if suppose you want to compare the different combinations of treatment also, in that case also we are preferring the factorial design of clinical trial. Suppose you want to check A, B, then A plus B, then B plus C, plus C plus D. So all these combinations you want to check, and your particular the outcome is same. So in that case also we are preferring factorial design of the clinical trial. Another design is your adaptive design. And adaptive, as it indicates, you have to adapt according to the situation. So that that actually the design is. So in adaptive design of clinical trial, now most of the investigators are preferring this, because in adaptive design you can do the changes on the basis of preliminary results. Suppose you got some results, and after 1 week of treatment, you want to change, you want to increase or decrease the subject, or you want to some changes in a designs, so you can do if you have prepared the adaptive design of clinical trial. So this is all about designs of the clinical trials. So I hope you get an idea what actually the different design of clinical trial and what are their advantages and limitations. So thank you very much. I hope next topic I will cover soon. Thank you very much.